If you're a reloader, chances are one of your biggest goals is to save money by shooting more for less. While most of us have analyzed the price of equipment and components, have you ever stopped to think about the materials you're using? The firearms industry is famous for taking everyday products and rebranding them as being specially made for guns, typically at a hefty and often unjustifiable price increase. In this video, we're going to take a look at some of the biggest ripoffs in common case cleaning media and chemicals, and how you can avoid paying ridiculous markups for them by using identical or nearly identical alternatives. Beginning with vibratory tumblers, the two most common cleaning media types are crushed corn cob and ground walnut. Both can be found in your local gun store in various sizes and brands. This RCBS corn cob media is fairly cheap at $23 for 4 pounds, or about $5.75 a pound. What you may not realize is this is nothing more than rebranded pet bedding. No, really. The exact same product can be found in just about any pet store that sells bird or reptile bedding for a fraction of the cost. This VitaCraft corn cob bedding works out to $2 a pound in an 8-pound package. If you buy it in bulk, you can get 50 pounds for $61, or about $1.22 a pound. Here's a bag of cob bedding I purchased several years ago for $25. I use it mainly on large diameter casings or to tumble my cast round balls and shot, and it works every bit as good as the stuff marketed as being specifically for firearms. Ground walnut, which is often marketed as being a superior tumbling media due to its finer size, is even cheaper. This 5-pound container of Range Max walnut tumbling media costs $20, or about $4 a pound. Once again, a visit to your local pet store will likely turn up a much cheaper alternative in the form of ground walnut pet bedding. Here we have a 50-pound bag for $60, or about $1.20 a pound, which probably sounds like a pretty good deal, right? Not really. You see, ground walnut is so cheap to produce, it's actually even used as a sandblasting medium. Any automotive or farm supply store will stock it in huge, generic bags. Here's a 50-pound bag from Princess Auto for $40, or about 80 cents a pound. Once again, here's a bag I bought several years ago, and just like the corn cob media, it never goes bad, so I can just take whatever I need whenever I want to tumble some pistol or rifle casings. For all the wet tumblers out there, let's talk about the scam that's Lemmyshine, touted by reloaders the world over as the be-all and end-all of wet tumbling additives. You won't believe how much you're overpaying for it. As of the recording date of this video, a normal bottle runs you about $6 a pound. That's not too bad considering you only use a couple spoonfuls at a time, but if you clean a lot of brass or you're a bullet swager, it starts to add up. What most people don't realize is Lemmyshine is really nothing more than citric acid powder and a little bit of lemon scent. If you've ever been down the baking aisle at your grocery store, you already know you can buy citric acid pretty cheap. But here's a tip for you. Citric acid is also used to make candles. If you really want to save on Lemmyshine, visit any candle making supply shop and you'll be amazed to discover that you can buy the generic stuff for about $1.76 a pound. If you buy it in bulk, that drops as low as $1.52 a pound. Once again, here's a huge 55-pound bag I bought several years ago. As with the corn cob and walnut media, it never goes bad. As an added bonus, if you have hard water where you live, a quarter cup of this stuff will make your dishwasher and everything else in it look like brand new. Hopefully a few of these tips will help you to shave a couple percent off your reloading costs. One thing I learned early on as a reloader is a little bit of comparison shopping goes a long way in getting the most bang for your buck.